Look at that. Waves to the right, I mean not breaking, but very shoaly water. 2.3 I've got underneath me here. I left Christchurch at about 7 o'clock this morning, went aground a couple of times on the way out, so I've left my mark in their harbour, which is good of me, and I'm just about to cross. My plan is to go to Chichester Harbour, which is right at the other end of the Solent, in time for an evening tide to get in the evening tide. And the wind is in the west, which is good. The beginning of this journey, though, the tide is slopping out of here. There's a Hurst Castle on this side and the Needles here. And you see those few. Yesterday I came through, the tide was really slopping out, and I don't really want to spend the day plugging that. My plan is to try and get it close to the Needles and sneak along the coast here, which is going to be a bit hard without an echo sounder. It's going to be a bugger without an echo sounder, actually, is what it's going to be. So here we are on the chart. You can see old Gordon was old school. Here's lots of pencil marks. I love his pencil marks on these charts. It's brilliant. Good to see. He was obviously very keen on keeping bearings. I don't know when he got a GPS, but must have been a great relief. So yesterday I was in Keyhaven, which is in here. Then I came out and round here. Slop in with the tide, cross here and into Christchurch Harbour. Today, I don't want to plug this. I was worried that I might get here and then I'd be having the engine running and roaring to try and get round this corner. I hope the tide will flow won't be quite so strong here. And so I'm going to come in this side. But I couldn't come straight across here because there's the dreaded Shingles Bank, which you can see dries. So I've had to come out to the edge of Shingles Bank to make sure I'm clearing it, and then in here. So when we get to this mark, whatever it is, this is no great journey in the annals of sailing. I'll just tell you how far it is to where I live. Bosham. Let's try Bosham. Go to 31 miles, it's not too bad. Tide should be behind me, the wind should be behind me for a fair amount of time, the tide will be with me. So 31 miles to Bosham, 15 hours at this speed, but I'll go faster. So I'm just going to see what the tide's doing, assume it's running out. Horrible. Okay, there we are. So this is a buoy called Bridge, and as you can see, the tide is ebbing. And it's going to be ebbing for about the next 5 hours, so I'm about to pass through one of the fastest flows on the Solent. However, you know, I mean, it's a broad reach, and we're making 2.8 knots against the tide, so that's pretty good. Here's the needles, and we're doing 2.6 knots in I don't know how much water. My guess is there's a knot of tide against me. Weird patch of water here. There's a spit comes out, but there's motorboats and stuff in here, so I'm sure I'll be fine. You can see that it's rough here, rough, 2 feet waves. There's obviously a lot of disturbance. The boat is pushing hard through the water, but the water's moving past the boat, so 1.9 knots. When I come out of this patch of water, she's suddenly going to surge forwards, I hope. 1.9 knots. Look at that, that's weird, isn't it? Okay, 2.2 knots, 2.3 knots. 2.3 knots, so surge, okay. Not quite a surge, but look at that, that's very strange. The Solent should be pretty interesting today because I'm going to do the length of the Solent on a pretty good sailing Saturday. Probably the first decent sailing Saturday of the year. So the races will have started. Usually it really kicks off after Easter, but the keynotes will be out. So there should be a few fleets of boats out. There might be some spinnakers. I'm sure the mobos will be out in force. So I should now be through this kind of tidal gate here. And as the Solent opens out, I shall get into the tidal stream will slacken and eventually will turn in my favour. Really interesting building to live in. After this, I really should start piling on the miles a bit, because now the Solent does open up and the tide will slacken. You can see how narrow this gap is, and this is the last kind of promontory. So after this is Lymington. We're basically going to go along the south shore of the Solent. So coming around here, you can see how narrow and deep it is, and then it all shallows off 10, 11 metres, slack, a bit faster across there. Well, it's just wide and deep, so, and eventually the tide will turn and be with me. So, hopefully we will get rid of these 2.2 knots and 1.5 knots, speed up a bit. Really good flow here. Wow. Okay, well, I got fed up with steering. I was doing about 2.4 knots. So, oh look, echo sound has gone again. As soon as I put the tiller pilot on, the echo sound goes. There's a connection. So the tiller pilot's on. Jenna was up, a bit rolled away. We're doing a measly 1.3 knots. However, it's lunchtime. Ramsted ledge, and the tide is still running against us. It will turn. Just had a count up, and there are 53 boats that I can see easily around me. I'm sure if I got the binocs out, I could probably double that number. It's a very, very busy place. And today, it's not a racing day today, really, so they're all cruisers. They're all kind of a bit like me, aimlessly travelling. Which is quite weird, isn't it? Very weird. I've just got the Jenna up. And really, what I'm doing is I'm just waiting for the tide to turn. We're still doing two knots, so I am making progress, but I was steering and doing 2.5 or 3 knots, but I'd rather chill out, and then as soon as the tide turns, we'll go zip. cows. The tide is really slopping nicely now. I'm at cows now, and we're doing 5 knots. So halfway down, so I'm coming along here. Cows, just back coming past here, and it's getting really busy now. Lots of shipping, lots of racing fleets, getting mad. First decent mobo of the day. Dreaded sunsail fleet. Fuel bank, still a massive ebb going. Which is why we're doing 5.6 knots. 10 miles to go to West Pole. 2 hours, a bit early really. Four knots, 6 miles to go, 1 hour and 20 minutes. Sorry about the plastic bags, but I haven't got a pennant yet. going to see for that sail.
Veering west 546, showers, good. Thames, Dover, White, Portland, Plymouth. West or southwest 4 or 5, veering northwest 3 or 4 for a time later. Mainly fair, moderate or good. Biscay, north veering northeast 4 or 5, fair, moderate or good. South Fitzroy, northeasterly 5 to 7, fair, good. North Fitzroy, variable 4, becoming northeasterly 4 or 5 later. Mainly fair.
Well, it's 5 to 6, and it's 37 miles or something, and it's taken me, I left at 7, so first bit was going at 1.5 knots against the tide, but now, since the tide turned, we've been going at kind of 6 knots, and I've just got back to West Pole, so I'm about to jibe. And then try to drive the Jenner. I've only got the Jenner up. It's really, wind's pretty strong. Very chippy, I have to say. And then enter the peace and quiet of Chichester Harbour. Haven't decided what to do tonight. Can't get back to the pontoon till about 10 or 10:30. So I may well go back later, or I'll just pick up a mooring somewhere and quietly sit for the evening, which is probably my favourite thing. 3.6 metres. I'm just waiting for it to get a little bit deeper. Coming soon!
And you do.